This video is for those women who agonize over every text and always seem to have trouble turning a first date into a second. I'm going to tell you when to text a guy after your first date and exactly what to say when you do so. Hi, I'm Amy North. As the author of The Text Chemistry System, I've been trying to discover which text messages make men excited to see you again and which turn them off. I don't normally advocate game playing, but right after a first date is a pivotal time, and one wrong move could lead to a problem. Basically, my biggest advice here is don't overthink it and don't overdo it. Don't double text, let him lead the conversation, and avoid ambiguity. Here's the risk you take by texting too much after the first date. At this point, you're riding high. You feel connected to this guy, and you're delighted by your great first date. You established a rapport in the way of talking to him. But if I know anything, it's that texting and talking in person are completely different. When we text, we're speaking much more briefly than we do in person. This means that if you try to match the energy of your first date, which is only natural if it went well, then there's a good chance you'll overwhelm him. Plus, men tend to be very wary of moving too fast. If you go from short flirty texts to big long paragraphs, then he might start to worry you're getting too comfortable. This is a red flag for many guys. Instead, if you keep calm and quiet, you'll actually make him want you more. Men are used to pursuing women, so they'll be comfortable with this dynamic. So all that aside, how can you show enthusiasm and let him know you had a good time without scaring him off? Without further ado, here's a text message you've been waiting for. I had so much fun last night. Smiley face. Boring, right? Maybe, but at this point, this guy knows 100% whether or not he wants to go out again. You just need to let him know they are also interested. Send this message in the afternoon, the day after your date. You don't need to send him a novel or tell him exactly when and where you want to meet next. Leave that up in the air and let him reach out. If you're comfortable and feel confident that the second date is in the bag, then feel free to chat a bit more. Just play it cool and keep your feelings to yourself for now. Remember, this time is crucial, and texting too much at this stage can do more harm than good. But what if the date didn't go well and you're looking for a second chance? In this case, I'd recommend you address the elephant in the room. You want him to know that you know it was a little awkward, but that it was abnormal for you and you want to give it another shot. Say this instead. I felt like I was a little off last night, but I think you're great. You up for round two? Addressing this awkwardness is a powerful opportunity for connection between the two of you because you're being vulnerable and honest. This is refreshing because so many people are trying to project the perfect version of themselves on the first date. If he knows you're willing to get real, then this will show him you're confident and self-aware. If you're interested in learning some foolproof texts with a bit more flair, head to coachnorth.com/texting now and check out my free video presentation. My text chemistry program contains dozens of tailor-made text messages that will catch his eye and make him see you in a new light. It's really simple once you get the hang of it. That's coachnorth.com/texting. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.